Number one. This first comment comes from Before I Wake, a Netflix film that tries to be a horror and more. I ended up reviewing it as if it achieved a deeper sense of theme and meaning, only to pull the rug from under my readers to mimic the film in devolving into a bluntly put creature film. And everyone loved that, and we can move on.
Theory is absolutely ridiculous. You went digging for metaphors, buried yourself so deep that you essentially created an entirely different movie in your head, then got disappointed that the film you imagined wasn't what you got.
I mean, to a degree, isn't that how we approach every film? I go into everything with at least some sense of that I might find some enjoyment in it. This is such an early review that I hope I've gotten better at clarifying that a movie isn't bad because it fails to deliver what I want from it. If BIW would have honed in on the child's imagination horror and just owned it, and it was just a horror film with that like concept, I would have thought that was awesome, and I would have credit for being that.
It wasn't just a creature movie. The message was about learning to let go and understanding how reality can become skewed by our subconscious. If you want a movie with a pointless extended metaphor blowing hot air at you for 90 minutes, go watch The Babadook.
Rude. Oh, Baba, no! Your comment is so damn accurate. Where do I begin? This is almost a self-satirization with how much overthinking was involved. I was prompted to analyze this film as someone told me they had guessed the twist right away. After watching the film, I thought that I could present my overspeculation as a way to address the two conflicting intentions by presenting the horror aspects as undercutting the psychological drama aspect, as well as prompting thought and discussion about interpretation of film and the concept of seeing art where it just isn't, and how when watching movies we are influenced by preconceived notions. I do enjoy being called out, because while I tried to point this out, I wasn't fair to this film. In retrospect, a creature movie is probably a gross oversimplification, though I do believe that everything leading up was more to give backstory to the creature than express a message on grief and the subconscious, but an interpretation of that is justifiably fair. I do thank you for taking the time to comment and giving your thoughts on the post and the movie. I'm certainly not free of criticism, and I'm very aware that the weird angle of this post is definitely one to criticize. I still very much hold this sentiment. I think a little bit of pushback is healthy. I would like it from a source that's a little less condescending. I knew these people were never coming back to respond, because they weren't WordPress bloggers, they were a search engine, they made an account like through that. But I think your comment exists so that the next reader can see them and, you know, respond in potentially an important impression. I think it's something you gotta recognize is when responding to critical comments, should I stand firm and show how much I agree with the initial language by doubling down, or do I want to mediate and alleviate some of the harshness or vagueness in my write-up? I understand how these people would be upset, so I tried to accept it, move forward, move on.
Oh, some people. I don't know where to begin on this. If you had watched the whole movie, maybe you would have caught it. But I'll take this rationally, or as much as I can. You cannot judge a movie you have not watched all the way through. Sit through a movie before you make your own decisions on it, honey. 'Cause what you've done is essentially watch one video about a surgery and assume you're a top-class surgeon. But the point I'm making is, watch a movie all the way through, then work out in your head if you should go spewing pointless words at everyone on the internet for attention. I came to your page hoping for a quality review on my favorite film, but instead, I got a run on sentences, lose points, and plots of an entirely different movie!
I've always been confused and have assumed that this comment is from the same person. It's 2 years old and it is one of my most viewed. It's hard for me to believe that in 2 years that the only two negative comments came within 5 minutes of each other and they're from completely two unrelated people. But I don't know. I'm going to be a little not as nice, just because, I mean, the irony of someone accusing me of not watching the film when they couldn't even finish reading my review. I do have to admit, though, I love the surgeon line. It's kind of funny. I do. I love it. I don't want to come across as defensive. Sigh. However, maybe if you read all the way through, you may have caught it, where I talked about the theory being completely disproven, and the point being to represent how I found the horror to undercut the psychological drama aspect, and ultimately made the story feel shallow, existing as an explanation for the canker man, rather than exploring the depth of potential provided by the premise. I do apologize for disappointing you. Never my intention, though I guess with the strange approach to discussing this movie, I was aware that some wouldn't be on board. I openly admitted I was unfair to the film, and I refused to call it a bad movie, as I did enjoy the premise and thought it was visually pleasant that, in my subjective opinion, didn't come together the best, but I'm glad that it could be enjoyed better by you and many others. Thank you for commenting and voicing your disdain, and don't worry, I don't think I'll perform surgery anytime soon.
Hello everyone, my name is Irina, and tonight I will be playing the role of Amy, October 22nd, 2020, at 11:19 p.m. Your version would have been so much better. Instead, what I saw was a boring, decidedly unscary, slow movie that had falsely been advertised as a horror. The only horror was that I wasted a couple of hours watching it. It went nowhere. Every scare was entirely predictable. It was just bad. I guess I should have expected nothing else from a Netflix movie. I definitely wish they'd made a movie based on your interpretation. If not scary, it would at the very least have been interesting.
Hey Amy, I'm glad to see you enjoyed my review / weird post on Before I Wake. It's truly nice to see someone agree with me, as my last commenter was not a fan of my off-kiltered approach. I thought this was a good film to address how interpretations and reactions to movies are often built on expectation. I agree with you, it felt unsatisfactory because it's not a very scary horror, but it also is too basic for a whimsical fantasy piece. I'm flattered that you enjoyed my interpretation. Maybe not a perfect idea, but one that is a conceptually fun and engaging. I don't know. I'm thinking of ending things is the closest thing I can think of that is a mix of horror with a psychological think piece. If you haven't checked it out, I would recommend it. Thanks, Amy. Thanks for Amy. I mean, give Amy a big round of applause. Beautiful performance. Always pleasant to see these other sides of the coin and recognize that your opinions are valid and appreciated. Gotta take the hate with the love. Live a healthy middle, you know? Number two. Draw fan art, I said. It would be fun, I said. Only a couple problems. One, I can't draw. And two, when you write something outside of your typical genre, you might encourage some new traffic. Oh boy.
Your deco is too good. I'd use her as a profile pic if I didn't have one already.
I just want to interrupt and say, please never do that. I would, you know, if you did this, like, oh god, no, don't, please don't do that. Please, I'm begging you, don't. I'll die. I don't know about that one, but I'm told it's better than My Invisible Man. Thanks for the nomination, I'm sure it'll be fun to answer.
That's what we call foreshadowing.
I mean, aside from the face, Dekamori is pretty good. Better than I could do. Really loved your opening lines and silly jokes here and there as well. Winky face.
I don't know about that. You're pretty crafty, so I'm sure you could make something pretty neat. Feel free to suggest anything for a potential follow-up.
Pretty great, Kay. Especially the Invisible Man. Is he caught in a snowstorm too? In general, miles better than I can do.
Thanks, Scott. Don't sell yourself short. I'm sure you could do better. And at least someone appreciates the Invisible Man.
You got me. I'm the one who's gonna be, patronizing. And tell you, like, anyone who makes some effort that they could do better with time and practice. I would have more unique fun with the Invisible Man. Sure, yours is mildly amusing, but are you the first to draw nothing? Come up with a unique hat, maybe gloves and shoes? Maybe he becomes invisible with a pocket tool / watch kept in an invisible pocket. So many possibilities.
And you got me. Ouch. It certainly wasn't because I had the two done, and instead of stopping there for the sake of time, thought of a mildly amusing insert to fully concede that this is all sort of a lighthearted joke that I'm not taking too seriously. I think it's a shame that your initial impression of me is unoriginal and lazy, when a lot of my content outside of that half-baked gag is to the contrary. So, the backstory for this post is I actually just had an Adobe Illustrator trial that was going to expire, so I thought it would be fun to try using the software, as I am kind of familiar with it. I was only just thinking of doing the two, and then make it a potential, like, three-part series, like, two, two, two. If there was interest, if people, you know, were interested. It was just that it felt weird that I wanted to do, you know, I wanted one movie rep, because I did video games, I did anime, but like I need a movie rep, and it just so happened that The Invisible Man was the most recent movie I saw in theaters, and it was kind of like a popular, like, pop culture thing, and it would be super easy to draw and it kind of be funny, because I think that's what I was, and even though it's obviously it's a joke, it was a joke, but at the same time, like, I just want everyone to know, like, I'm not trying to draw serious fan art, so please, you know, go easy on me. I don't know, even though you're not trying that hard, you're still somewhat subconscious about it, and that's maybe where this altercation comes from. I don't know. I don't necessarily disagree, and I respect your opinion. I do think that you have some fun ideas, so if you were to put them pen to paper and come up with some inventive and unique art, I'll be the first to hit the like button.
How long have you been blogging here? You know, I started with movie reviews of my own a little over 10 years ago. That's a challenge. I just might post a half dozen invisible folks of various natures for your enjoyment, should you choose to enjoy my style.
That would be a fun idea. Congrats on 10 years. I am definitely several years short of that milestone.
There ain't nothing to congratulate other than stubbornness to give this up. I have tried so hard to connect with so many, and after losing a blog that was like a very grim but social sesame street, with plenty of lost, like the TV show that leaves people lost, souls exchanging everything under the sun, and after 10 years I feel almost as empty as when I started. Every gain seems to slip through my fingers and disappear. And ghosts and weird corporation faces keep following me around.
I don't think I knew how to respond to that. How do you respond to very grim but social Sesame Street? With plenty of lost, like the TV show, lost souls. Exchanging everything under the sun. How does one respond to that? Finally, a pinky comet we can return to normalcy.
Also, did I miss somewhere the other 3 of 6 characters you were challenged to draw? If you need a new list, I could give you one.
I wanted to break it up into parts to see if people were interested in this, and for that very reason, I would love suggestions of what people would like to see.
I noticed you say where when you mean were. Were interested? Not where interested. Did their interests go? I don't know. But I am thinking you're still in school and struggling with English lit. Okay. New list idea. And it has to be anime/manga related? I'm a little Americanized, so I'm not as wise to every little series out there. But I will suggest Squirtle, Swabbit, and Alchemy from Pokemon.
Okay, I do want to address this. Is the phrase Americanized him trying to be racist? Because I knew he doesn't know what I look like and just assumes I'm a message weeb because I watch things like The Invisible Man and Pokemon. But like, is it racist? Is it? I don't know. I don't want to be making accusations. It kind of came across that way. Like, I'm Americanized. I'm like, yeah, me too. So I also think the English lit thing was like, haha, this isn't your first language. And I'm like, but it is. Hard to believe sometimes, but it is.
Sword and Shield. And then Totoro from My Neighbor Totoro. A Tree of Coal / Dismites from A Spirited Way. and lastly, going way back for my super challenge and your skills. I'll seek out an image of Lipumira from an anime series called Maps.
Doesn't necessarily have to be anime manga. I too am very Americanized. However, these are already some solid suggestions. I don't know why you're speculating / projecting based off a minor typo, but I would say I was a pretty good English / lit student. Guys and gals, I was just trying to save face. Of course, I have a crippling struggle with English / lit. It is a defining character trait of mine that I wouldn't just put it in my Twitter bio because I think it's funny to own a completely false insult. Come on, guys. You know the truth. We all know. Don't worry. I'm not lying.
You say that, but Jigglypuff and maybe the Invisible Man count as what I know in the U.S. I thought that girl was Sailor Moon. But I see she is not. Just has similar hair.
Sailor Moon? Actually, you know what? He's right.
I just found it something worth picking. As a grammar Nazi and grilled English student long ago. And if I ever misspell a word, feel free to call me out on it. Bragging you are educated and then making typos gets my dander up and makes me speak out in a critical way. I'm astounded by how many bestseller authors have famous works literal typos.
You have to be trolling. There's no way you could screw up grammar Nazi with a typo. The universe is just handing it to me. How can you take it seriously? I don't know. I just thought it was funny. Like, out of all the words to typo, it would be grammar. I mean, I get it. My friend is a real grammar Nazi as well, so I've learned to take it in good humor. I do like your sense of irony in spelling grandma wrong. It can certainly be frustrating when presented professionals fail to meet such standards. I most certainly don't make such braggart claims because I know I'm an idiot who will certainly make mistakes here and then her and there. Also, I want to come clean. I was thinking of intentionally leaving a notable typo just to grind his gears a bit. However, her and there was an honest mistake. I know some of you will give me credit that obviously I'm yanking on his chain a bit, but no, I made a typo. Whoopsie. I don't know, I also went on to question why the Invisible Man is something he doesn't know about. It's a decently popular, kind of a big deal this year for movies.
Did you not just previously say something about being educated? No, edumacated, making mistakes. Her and there, eh? What year was this? I don't remember any Invisible Man movie. Not since Kevin Bacon made one. It could not have been a big movie if I heard nothing about it. Okay, dude.
You're right, me with my obscure movies. Has anyone ever told you that you must be fun at parties? Don't worry, I'll see if I can work towards getting you less dictionaries and more movie tickets for your birthday. Might help you get out of your dark and Sesame Street state of existence. See, I can be an asshole, but still be very chipper about it. It's kind of scary. I mean, with the high and mighty routine this man is pulling, you would have to think he must be running like the world's greatest blog, right? And well, of course, I had to see what he does. You know, I know, maybe we could become friends and mutual followers after this. And I don't get it. I don't know, buddy. Recently just seems to bitch about how nobody wants to talk to him. And with a pleasant conversation such as this, color me surprised. And that was the end of it. I always like comments from random strangers like this that really make each post worth it. You know, in a sense. Even when they're sour comments, if one person, you know, it says they like to cheer their day up, I mean, that's the goal, right? I don't know. Ultimately, kind of pitied Mr. Bolt, as I assume they were probably just someone, maybe a little lonely, and not very good at expressing or socializing themselves. That's why I think you always, you know, gotta love thy neighbor, but, you know, love thy enemy, love thy internet troll. I tried to direct the conversation away from the insult and, you know, roll with the punches a bit, but I don't know. At some point, I'm not a doormat, so if you're gonna be rude, I might take some jabs myself. I don't know what to tell you. I hate feeling like I stooped to their level. And while nothing really bothered me, I jest about it. I jest about it to this day. It doesn't bother me.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
I still had to ask some people to kind of go over the interaction. I just give me the straight answer of like, do I look bad? That's the last thing I want to do, is come across as hostile or like a bully. I mean, I don't know. He was the aggressor. I think everyone can agree with that. I tried to be, you know, polite. I do, you know, not object their opinion. But same time, I mean, I don't think I'm a bully. That's not me. Glad I'm not a female who has to deal with more heinous interactions. I can only imagine the kind of crap you would have to deal with. Or that Mr. Bull, you know, became a constant presence on my blog. I kind of worried a little bit. I'm like, is this guy gonna come and back every week and just shit on me? Please don't, Mr. Bolt, I don't want you around. I couldn't imagine having, you know, a toxic commenter just frequent my posts. I mean, it's the internet. I'd be fine with it. I would understand that that's comes with the territory, but like, I don't know, I'm still small, so like, please don't. Number 3, boss baby comment. This is one of my favorite comments of all time. I think it's funny because I wasn't even that hateful towards the boss baby. I wasn't even that hateful towards the boss baby, relatively speaking. I actually said that as an absurd premise, it actually isn't that terrible of a job. And both the movie and the show, you know, they have their moments. Not great moments, but they have moments. I cannot recommend the boss baby review enough. It was so much fun to remove so much context out of the boss baby and, you know, lampoon it for just the pure weirdness it supplies. It's the gift that keeps on giving, and I still can't believe that someone created this account for this. I mean, look at this. Wait a minute. Screenshot. Well, thanks for recounting some of my comment horror stories. Hopefully you found them spooky, insightful, humorous. I don't know what we're going for here, but hope you enjoyed. I promised that I wouldn't be too mean, so hopefully I wasn't. I don't know. I think you've got to find the balance to accept the criticism, but not tolerate the attitude or aggression behind it. So, you know, don't let other people make yourself uglier. I'm not on a high horse, are fond of, you know, slinging mud. So hopefully I kept it fun, even when my, you know, sarcastic and cynical side kind of went on the defensive. Hope you enjoyed. Big thanks to my friends who cameoed in this video. Links will be in the description so you can go give them a big thanks for all the wonderful content they make and, you know, comments they leave. Appreciate having all of you, you know, joining me for this. So thank you guys very much. I have more videos, so feel free to go watch them. And, you know, leave a comment. Leave a comment so rude that I have to make a sequel to this post. You know, thanks for stopping by, and I will see you at the movies. I don't know about that. You're pretty crafty, so I'm sure you could maybe... Yeah, just imagine if I responded like that. That's the end of the video.
Thank you very much. Also, Irina here again. Netflix makes some really great anime. If you haven't seen them, you should check them out.